Hey everyone, it's Caitlin Caggiano here for Premier Guitar. In this video, we're going to be looking at the CAGED system, but specifically how we can use the CAGED system to create a blueprint for any key. The CAGED system is one of the best tools we have to navigate the fretboard. Understanding the CAGED system will greatly improve your skill set for both rhythm and lead playing. The CAGED system, spelled C-A-G-E-D, is built off of the five open chord shapes of C, A, G, E, and D. If you understand these five open chord shapes, you have what you need to begin to master the entire fretboard. The first step to understanding the CAGED system is to create a movable bar chord out of each of these five shapes. You can create a movable bar chord out of each of these five open chord shapes by following three simple steps. Step one, reposition the fingers so the index finger is free. The index finger will be your bar. Step two, shift all of the fingers up by one fret. Step three, place the index finger bar down on the first fret. Now you technically don't need the index finger bar on any string that is sonically lower than the lowest root. For this C shape, you really only need it on the G string directionally down. You now have a movable C-shaped bar chord. You can now do the same thing for the remaining four shapes. For the A shape, reposition the fingers, shift everything up by one fret, and place the bar down. You now have your movable A shape. For the G shape, make sure the index finger is free, shift everything up by one fret, and place the bar down. Now, an easier way to fret the G shape is with the pinky on the low E string and the ring finger on the A string. You now have a movable G shape. For the E shape, reposition the fingers so the index finger is free. Shift everything up by one fret and place the bar down. You now have your movable E shape. For the D shape, reposition the fingers so the index finger is free. Shift everything up by one fret, place the bar down. On the D string, you really only need it on the D string directionally down. Now you have your movable D shape. Now when learning these five CAGED system shapes, it's also important to understand where the lowest root is for each of these five shapes. This will help you when you're connecting shapes, forming chords, and also playing scales. The root of the C shape is on the A string. The root of the A shape is also on the A string. The root of the G shape is on the low E string. The root of the E shape is also on the low E string. The root of the D shape is on the D string. Now let's connect five shapes of the same chord. We're going to start by connecting the five shapes of the C chord. Start with the C chord in the C shape. Whenever you're connecting from the C shape to the A shape, go to the furthest fret of the C shape, so that would be the third fret. That is where the index finger bar will go for the next shape. Index finger bar in the third fret, C in the A shape. When you're connecting from the A shape to the G shape, the same rule applies. Go to the furthest fret of the A shape, that's the fifth fret. This is where the index finger bar will be placed for C in the G shape. When connecting the G shape to the E shape, the same rule applies. Go to the furthest fret of the G shape, that's the 8th fret. Index finger bar goes down on the 8th fret, you have C in the E shape. When connecting the E shape to the D shape, the same rule applies. The furthest fret of the E shape is the 10th fret. Index finger bar goes down on the 10th fret, you now have C in the D shape. Once you have gone through all the five CAGED shapes of any chord, you can keep going. So after the C chord in the D shape, I'm going to go into C chord in the C shape again, but this time it'll be an octave higher. Whenever you go from the D shape to the C shape, it's what I refer to as completing the cycle. When you complete the cycle by connecting the D shape to the C shape, the rule we've been using will change by one fret. So when you connect the D shape to the C shape, instead of going to the furthest fret, go back to the second to last fret. So I place my index finger bar on the 12th fret. I now have C in the C shape an octave higher. So I have C in the C shape, C in the A shape, C in the G shape, C in the E shape, C in the D shape, and C in the C shape an octave higher. Now you can do this for any other major chord. For example, if I'm going to connect the five shapes of the C sharp or D flat chord, I simply shift everything up by one fret. C sharp in the C shape. Furthest fret, C sharp in the A shape. Furthest fret, C sharp in the G shape. Furthest fret, C sharp in the E shape. Furthest fret, C sharp in the D shape. If I wanted to go an octave higher of the C shape, second to last fret, bar goes down, C sharp in the C shape. Now you can use this method for any chord and you can try it chromatically up the fretboard of the guitar, but what you may find is you might run out of room. For example, let's connect the five cage system shapes of a B chord. Now I'm first going to find the B chord in the C shape. The B chord in the C shape is right here with the root on the 14th fret and the index finger bar on the 11th fret. So let's now connect the five shapes of the B chord. Start with B chord in the C shape. Now the furthest fret for the C shape is the 14th fret. I can place my index finger bar down on the 14th fret for B in the A shape. Now when you've reached a shape where the index finger bar is either on or past the 12th fret, you can take it down the octave. This B chord in the A shape has the index finger bar on the 14th fret. That's definitely on or past the 12th fret. So I can take this B chord in the A shape and bring it down the octave. This is how you bring it down the octave. Whatever fret your index finger bar is on, in this case it would be the 14th fret, subtract that fret number by 12. 14 minus 12 is 2. So I'm going to take this same shape, B in the A shape, and I'm going to move it down so that the index finger bar is on fret 2. So I have the B chord in the C shape, now connected to the B chord in the A shape, but I've brought it down the octave. Now I can continue connecting the remaining shapes. Remember our rule, A shape connected to the G shape, go to the furthest fret. That would be the 4th fret. Place the index finger bar down on the 4th fret. Here's the B chord in the G shape. When I'm connecting the G shape to the E shape, furthest fret, that's the 7th fret. Index finger bar down on the 7th fret for the B chord in the E shape. When I'm connecting the E shape to the D shape, furthest fret, that's the 9th fret. Index finger bar down, I have B in the D shape. Now going from the D shape to the C shape, I can complete the cycle. Go to the second to last fret, that's the 11th fret, bar goes down. I should finish where I started with B in the C shape. Now what we've done here is connect the five cage shapes for any major chord. But we're gonna change our mindset a little bit. Instead of thinking about this as five shapes of the same chord, we're going to now think about this as five shapes of the key. Again, the purpose of this video is to understand how the cage system shapes can be used to find the blueprint of the key. So I could think about this as five shapes of the C chord, or I could think about this as the five shapes that become the blueprint of the key of C. Each of these five cage system shapes of the key of C are now going to be used as boxes for any scale in the key of C. This snapshot of the fretboard is going to be my first box, the C shape. This snapshot of the fretboard is going to be my second box, the A shape. This snapshot of the fretboard is going to be my third box, the G shape. This snapshot of the fretboard is going to be my fourth box, the E shape. And this snapshot of the fretboard is going to be my fifth box, the D shape. These five shapes are now the blueprint of the key of C because they form the boxes of my scale shapes. Let's try this out for the major pentatonic scale. Now, because we're in the key of C, we're going to be using the C major pentatonic scale. But the beautiful thing about the cage system is whatever I'm doing for the key of C, I can easily do for any other key. The major pentatonic scale is formed by using five notes of the major scale. Penta means five. The pentatonic scale is going to use the 1, 2, 3, 5, and 6 of the major scale. You can think about it like this. It's the major scale, but I've removed the 4th and the 7th. The C major pentatonic scale are the notes C, D, E, G, and A. So the C major pentatonic scale in the C shape is going to include every C, D, E, G, and A in this box of the fretboard. Here's the C major pentatonic scale in the C shape. Notice when I finished that scale shape, I landed on the C chord in the C shape. This allows me to visualize the cage system shape where this scale shape is coming from. It also allows my ear to sonically imprint on that C major tonality. Here's the C major pentatonic scale in the A shape. Here's the C major pentatonic scale in the G shape. Here's the C major pentatonic scale in the E shape. And now the C major pentatonic scale in the D shape. Thank you. Just like we connected the five cage system shapes for any chord, you can now create this blueprint and find these pentatonic boxes for any key. The cage system is so beneficial for your lead playing, and I say the cage system is a great equalizer. It can make every key simple because we're dealing with the same five shapes. Have fun with this. Try this for the key of C or any other key, and happy practicing.